I'm Nicanor Perlas from the Philippines.
Okay. Yeah. What do you see the major challenges for humanity to be in the next decade?
Our major challenges is to prevent the mechanization of nature and the human being and of society. And this will come about through the massive deployment of nanotechnology, biotechnology, information technology and cognitive technology all coming together to produce a totally unknown world that is almost fully mechanized. So this for me is the greater challenge, even greater than climate change. Because here we're talking about the possibility of the extinction of the human species. So that's a real challenge, and we need to develop our gifts, especially our creative gifts, and our capacity to love and really be with the world to handle this.
Okay, and then what skills and capacities need to be developed to meet these challenges?
Okay, I mentioned about that a little bit, but the most important experience of all, capacity, is to be able to find our true source, the true center of our existence, of our beingness, of our being human. When we discover that, we discover our very deep interconnection with the world, how actually we become one with the processes in the world, with the forces of the world that are creating the world. This is who we are inside, our deepest core. And when we find that, there will be a very different perspective about what these technologies are trying to do. Because here, when we enter that space, we experience the power to reshape society, to reshape the world according to the human image. And now we find a development that would like to create this image of a machine, a giant machine. And that the contrast of the two will be so stark that people who have this creative experience will do something to change the future of the world.
Okay. What do you see the role of youth to be in this process?
The youth is very important because this kind of creativity is natural for them. If it doesn't get suppressed by drugs or by loss of meaning, by structures in society and so on, it's natural for young people to be creative because they have the youthful forces, but at the same time, they're not yet so brainwashed by society. Because when a person is brainwashed or programmed, the creativity is trapped inside the person, it cannot come out. So that's why young people are going to be absolutely essential in this process, because the young people carry this creative process as a kind of natural part of their own development. If they don't develop it, they lose it, and they become very old, even while they're young. So I would say young people who do not develop their creativity become very old, because if they're not creative, then the past is all they do, and the past is very old. So there's both an opportunity and a threat for young people, but it's absolutely essential for them to engage in this question.
What gives you hope for the future?
Wow, there's a lot of things that I can hope for the future. People, individuals feel a sense of disempowerment. This thing is so large, the systems are so big. But on the other hand, if you're super creative and you've awakened this creative force and you see all kinds of interconnections and possibilities that cannot have not been seen before, then you can start putting your will and making those connections real, those new connections. Just sounds abstract, I'll give an example. One woman, forgot her name, said that it's really disgusting that we have these landmines and my life will be devoted to getting rid of these landmines. And she did this in less than 10 years. She was galvanized people support behind a global treaty banning landmines. One person against a global system that produced landmines. We have stories of this, of people organizing together to challenge large systems. There have been failures, but there have also been successes. So this is not a predetermined future. We have created it. We have created the mess, and we have the creative power to untangle that mess and create a very different world. That's my hope. And in my own life, I've experienced that so many times, actually winning against very large systemic battles, whether it's pesticides or nuclear power or trading arrangements or sustainable development, tobacco control, whatever. We've experienced victories because we've learned how to work together.
Final question. Imagine to be dropped on a deserted island with only one thing you are allowed to bring. What should it be?
I bring my total self-presence and attention and creativity. I don't need any external tools. I can create it in the process.